Well, you are from the army of God. You are the army of God. Praise God, praise God, praise God. Lord, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for bringing me here, Lord. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Brother and sister, I thought today the best is tell you my testimony. Glory to your name. The word of God said in Revelation chapter 12, verse 11, they defeated the devil. They defeated the devil by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. Glory to your holy name, Lord. A testimony is a powerful weapon. You know, there is a meeting now. There is a board meeting in hell. Satan is meeting with all his deputy. They are worried. What's going to happen today? Someone is going to give his testimony. They are trembling. And we are going to trample under our feet. Boom, boom, boom. Glory to your name, Lord. Glory to your holy name. Glory to your holy name. I'm going to take this away. It's better like that. I'm in direct contact. Praise God, praise God. Brothers and sisters, I was born 80 years ago. I am 80 years old, look. Our God. You know, God promised to renew our strength like eagles. This is what he did with me. This is what he wants to do with you. If you walk with him, if you are serious with him. If there are people here trying to count the years, when they will be 60 years old to take their retirement, I have news for you. There is no retirement to the Lord. You know what is the definition of an old person? What is an old person? If you open the dictionary and you look old, what does it say? What is old? When I was 20 years old, I looked at a man and he was 40 years old. And I said, 40 years old, look at this, he is old. So old is 40 years old, it's old. But when I reached 40 years old myself, I said, no, 40 years old, it's a baby. But I looked at a woman, she was 60 years old, and I said, 60 years old, this is old. So an old person is a person who has 60 years old. But when I reached 60 myself, I said, 60 years old, this is not old. This is the beginning of life. But I looked at someone who is 80 years old and I said, 80 years old, this is old, this is old. But now I am 80 years old and I don't feel old at all. So then what is the definition of a word old? An old person is any person who has 20 years more than me. I was born in Lebanon from a poor family, and I want to be happy in life. Is there anybody present here who doesn't want to be happy? No. You all want to be happy. I want to be happy. And I thought, to be happy, I need to have money, I need to have power, and I need to have all the pleasure in life. And the best pleasure I thought is sex. People tell me, don't preach, don't say sex when you preach. So I answer them, the devil is using sex, and we should fight the devil with our own weapons. We should tell the truth. Okay, then, money, power, and sex will make me happy. Okay, in order to have the third one, sex, I thought the best way is to get married. When you get married, you can have as much as you want, and it's for free. I got married, but after 3 months, oh, it's boring. It's boring. What did I do? George El Khoury, what did you do? What did you do? You are stuck with one woman when King Solomon had 1,000 women? It is not fair. What to do? Okay, if I get children, children will make me happy. They will run, they will laugh. It's beautiful to have children running in the house. Maybe this will make me happy. So I made 4 children, one after the other. Pam, 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 pam. Here they are, 4 children. But they were not laughing. They were not running between doors and laughing and bringing joy. They were crying. They wanted milk. They wanted to be clean. They made pee pee and things. Who is going to clean them? Who is going to do that? George El Khoury, you wanted to be happy. You are stuck with a woman, one, and you are stuck with 4 children. What's wrong with you? What's happening to you? You know what I did? I left my wife, I left my children, I divorced my wife, and left Lebanon, and left everybody, and came to Europe in Brussels, and I said, George El Khoury, here you are, you have no family, you have no children, you have no wife, you are free, now be happy, be happy. All I want is to be happy. I start working at Crédit Lyonnais. Who knows Crédit Lyonnais? Who knows Crédit Lyonnais? It's one of the biggest banks in the world. And slowly and gradually, I advanced in the bank. My salary increased. I have some people under my authority already. And with that, I had no problem in having girlfriends. So I took a girlfriend. But after 3 months, it's boring. It's boring. What did I do? I left her. I took another one, younger. I spent 3 months with her, and it's becoming boring. It seems to me that 3 months is the maximum I could spend with a woman. But I was not happy. I had this, but I was not happy. Hey, I'm looking for happiness. What am I going to do? Okay, George, if you get more money, if you get more power, you have now only 7 people under your authority. If when you get more, when you have more women, you will be happy. So I said, okay. I was not happy with every woman, every 3 months, one woman. I said, okay, let me have several at the same time. But I tried this, and I was not happy. My salary increased, and now I have more people under my command. Still not happy. I tried. Was not happy. I succeeded very much, very well in the bank, in Crédit Lyonnais. So Crédit Lyonnais did bring me to the head office in Paris and promoted me. Okay, here in Crédit Lyonnais in Paris, one of the biggest banks in the world, my rank in the hierarchy of the bank was above 20,000 people. 20,000 people, brother and sister, this is power. This is power. And my salary became really very, very high. Wow, I have now a lot of money. I have power. And I tried everything with the ladies, with the women. It did not work. I said, okay, let me try one woman every day. So I got one woman every day, except Thursday was my day of rest. But one day, unfortunately, I met with a beautiful, beautiful lady, and Thursday was gone. There was no rest anymore. But I was not happy. I tried really everything I can. You know, I had an agenda with me, with the name of all the ladies, to know which one I should invite. I don't want to invite some ladies on the wrong time. So I kept an agenda to know when I should not invite them. I'm telling you this to know how sophisticated I was in order to look for happiness. And I did not find it so far. Well, where is happiness? Why I am not happy? What's happening? Why I'm not happy? Hey, 15 years ago, brother and sister, 15 years ago, I was at the age of 65. I was in London. I was the chief executive, the general manager, the big boss of two banks in London. At the same time, I was the boss of one bank in Houston, here in the USA. Three banks in the same time. Do you know anybody who is the boss of three banks in the same time in the world? I didn't know anybody. I knew only one. It was me. I did set up myself this bank. I created this bank myself from scratch. And I created more. As a matter of fact, I did set up five banks in the world. Five banks in the world, brother and sister. I became very famous, very important in London, known all over the world. I had relation all over the world. I had relation with presidents, with ministers, with powerful men all over the world. I became very famous. I became very rich, a lot of money. I thought maybe if I buy apartments, if I have properties all over the world, maybe I'll be happy. So I bought apartment. My apartment in Paris was in Avenue Foch, the best avenue in the world. My apartment in the USA was in New York at the Trump Plaza. Who knows Trump Plaza? One of the most beautiful building in the USA. My apartment was at 42nd floor. I remember the airplane would fly below me. But my mansion in London, when I was living, it was a huge mansion. My garden was as big as a football field. I used to play golf in the garden, in my garden. But I was still not happy. Hey, what's happening? I have a lot of money now. I have a lot of power. I am the boss of several banks at the same time. I'm a chairman of this, chairman of that, founder of this, founder of that, a very famous person. Why I'm not happy? Why I'm not finding happiness? You know, there is an emptiness here. Even if you own the whole world, there's an emptiness here that you are trying to fill it. You want to fill this emptiness. It's empty here. It's empty. Whatever you do, it's empty. And you want to fill it. You want to fill it. So I'm talking to all businessmen and businesswomen, whether here or whether this program will go on TV, to tell them, I know you are looking for something to fill this emptiness who is here. And you are trying to fill it with money, with power, with sex, with pleasure, and still empty. I want to tell them, hey, I found this something you are looking for. I found it. As a matter of fact, it is not something. It is someone, and his name is Jesus Christ. But by that time, I didn't care about anybody. All I care, me, I want to be happy, and I was not happy. I had so many girlfriends, several hundred, and finally, I believe I did reach the number of King Solomon, 1,000 women. I know that many of you here are thinking, hey, this guy, how 1,000 women? Wow, if I can have half of that, it will be good for me. But I'm telling you this, brother and sister, to tell you not to try it, because you will not find happiness in this. You will not even find pleasure in this. You will find problems. You will find guilt. You will find misery. You will find suicides. You will find tentative of suicide. You will find suffering. You will find that you are breaking homes and personalities. This is the truth. And in addition, brother and sister, I'm not telling you about the illnesses. I'm not telling you about sexually transmitted illnesses. I spent hours and days and months in pharmacies. This is the truth, brother and sister, you are hearing. Don't try it. It is not worth it. It will not make you happy. If you are thinking, hey, I'm fed up with my wife. I'm fed up with my husband. What about looking for something younger? I will exchange my wife of 40 years old with two ladies, 20 each. If you are thinking that way, Don't think it. You will lose your time. It will not work. I tried it for you. It will not work. If you have a problem in your marriage, there is one solution which will bring happiness in your marriage. Submit to the Lord Jesus Christ and ask Him to heal your marriage. And He will give you back the love of your youth. Glory to your holy name, Lord. Glory to your holy name. But by that time, I did not care about Jesus Christ. I did not care about anybody. All I did care was is me. The Prime Minister of England, John Major, his name was, used to invite me for a dinner of bankers. I used to refuse the invitation. I will send my deputy. I was not interested in the Prime Minister. In order to spend a weekend with my girlfriend in the USA, I would fly Concorde plane. The ticket will cost now maybe $20,000 or $25,000. I used to take Concorde plane to come and spend one weekend with my girlfriend in New York. I came often to New York, and when the plane will land in New York, in John Kennedy Airport here near you, not far from here, a helicopter will be waiting for me. I will leave the plane and get up all immediately in the helicopter, and the helicopter will take me to the building just in front of the building, Trump Plaza. Someone like me will not take limousines or chauffeur-driven car, certainly not taxi, because my taxi there was helicopter. But I was still not happy. What should I do? What should I do to be happy? I give you an example that I gave this morning. In my beautiful mansion and my big garden, I used to make barbecue every weekend, and my garden was on the River Thames. The River Thames of England passed through my garden. So the boats will go through my garden, boarding my garden, and the people in the boat will see me with all these girlfriends and the barbecue and the smoke on the barbecue, and they'll say like this, hey. And they are thinking, they are saying, wow, look at this man, how happy he is. Look at these girlfriends. There is about 12 here. In red, in blue, in green, in yellow. They are all beautiful and young. And look, he is having a barbecue in his garden. What a happy man. But you know, brother and sister, I was not happy in this house. I was not happy in this garden. You know why I was not happy? Because I wanted a bigger garden. I wanted a bigger house. There is no satisfaction in this world. There is no satisfaction in this world. The human being was created to have a direct personal relationship with God through Jesus Christ. Without such relation, it's impossible to find satisfaction. There is no satisfaction in this world. There is no happiness in this world without Jesus Christ of Nazareth. One day, one of my sons that I left when he was little came to England counting on me to help him. I was buzzed because he came. I said, what is he doing here? Why is he coming? My past is catching me up. He's going to bother me. What am I going to do with my girlfriend? Every weekend they'll come. What am I going to do with him? So I gave him the choice. Look, either you disappear during the weekend, or I will lock you in a room. What do you choose? So he often choose to be locked in the room. But he asked for one condition. Dad, before you lock me in the room, let me look through the hole of the door, how she is like. So he will come and look at the door and say, oh, Dad, she is beautiful. Wow, You are a hero. You are wonderful. Bravo, Dad. Bravo, Dad. Bravo, Dad. Bravo, Dad. So it was fine. My son became my friend, and he was approving me and applauding me and proud of me. But one day, he was with me in the car, and he looked different. He looked different. I was worried. He was not laughing anymore. He was not applauding my conquests anymore. And I thought, hey, what's wrong with you? Why you are not talking? What's happening to you? He said, oh, Dad, I cannot listen to your stories anymore. I cannot listen to your life anymore. I am changed. Something happened to me. Hey, what happened to you? What happened to you? He said, I met someone who changed my life. He said. Who is this guy? What did he do to you? He said, I met someone. His name is Jesus Christ. He changed. And he changed my life. I'm not the same person anymore, Dad. Look, I'm different. I cannot listen to your stories. And you know, Dad, I cannot lie anymore. And this was the biggest insult he will tell me. What do you mean you don't lie anymore? My son, you are the son of George El-Khoury. Nobody succeeds without lying in life. You have to lie to succeed. I said, no, Dad, no. With Jesus Christ, we succeed and we don't lie. And he tried to convince me to accept his Jesus Christ, me. So I insulted him, I persecuted him, I told him, you are an idiot, get out of here. So I persecuted him during 2 years. I used to call him the idiot, from this moment, because he accepted someone, his name is Jesus Christ. Idiot. But while I was persecuting him for 2 years, I knew later that he was praying for me. He was praying for me during 2 years. And after these 2 years, a big problem happened to me. One of the ladies that I have an affair with came to me and blackmailed me. And she said, Mr. General Manager, Mr. George El-Khoury, I am falling down. You lied to me, I'm falling down, I'm going to expose you. Tomorrow I'm going to tell the board of directors of the banks about your life of debauchery. I'm going to tell them about your relation with me, this forbidden relation, because I'm one of your employees and you abused me. And this was the time when there was trials going on in the UK about sexual harassment in the enterprises. And this was one of them. And she said, tomorrow, Mr. General Manager, you are going to fall because everybody is going to know your story. Everybody is going to know your life of debauchery. And you know what? She was right. I would have lost everything. I was very known in London and in the world. And this story would have reached the newspaper. It would have been a big scandal in London. I would have lost everything, my position, my income, my girlfriend, and my friends. I was devastated. What would I do? I am finished. What did I do? I called the idiot. And I told him, you idiot, come here. So the idiot came. And I told him, look, your father is finished. Tomorrow morning, he is going to lose everything. And there is going to be a big scandal. Get ready, it's over. But my son laughed and said, Dad, you know everybody? You know the prime minister? You have friends all over the world? Nobody can help you? I told him, nobody, my son. Nobody, idiot. Nobody can help me. And he said, but I know someone who can help you. I know someone who can help you. Who can help you? He said, his name is Jesus Christ. Again, he said, Dad, Jesus Christ is the only one who can help you. But if Jesus Christ will solve your problem tonight, would you change your life of debauchery? Would you tell the woman living in your house to leave? I told him, look, idiot. I am a banker. I make contracts. If Jesus Christ can solve my problem tonight, I sign a contract with him. He solved my problem tonight, and I will promise him no sex outside marriage. Amen. This is the deal. And my son deal, okay, deal accepted. Let's go home. We went home, and here he stood up, and he started talking, or praying, or talking with a strange language. Wait, what's happening to this guy? What is he saying? What is this? I never heard something like that. Strange. What happened to him? The idiot became also mad. But I was so desperate. I was so desperate at that time, I accepted everything. When he finished, he said, call. Call now this lady on the phone. I made the number, brother and sister. And this lady answered from the first ring. Hey, brother and sister, nobody answered the first ring. You let it ring three times to make them anxious. But she answered the first ring. And her voice was different. There was no more threats, no more blackmail. She assured me in a nice voice that she is my friend. She will remain loyal and faithful, that I have nothing to worry about. There is no problem. And she wants to help me as much as she could. Oof. Oof. Well, this Jesus Christ? The problem is over. No more blackmail. It's finished. Jesus Christ, who are you? Who are you, Jesus Christ? So this proud man, his knees never knelt almost to anybody, fell on his knees. And I said, Jesus Christ, you heard me? You solved my problem? You kept your part of the contract? You are really the Son of God? You are God? You are God who can see, who can hear, who can answer? Yeah. Who does miracles? You filled your part of the contract? And me, I am going to fill my part of the contract. I promise you. No sex outside marriage. And in addition, I want to know you. I want to know you. And my son, the idiot, who was standing near me, did put his hand on my head and led me to salvation prayer. I went on my knees, full of blackmail, full of problem, full of worries, full of hurt, full of unforgiveness, full of heaviness, full of sins, full of unhappiness, and I stood up. All the heaviness was gone. All the problems are gone. I felt all the sins are gone. I was washed. All the hurt was gone. All the unforgiveness was gone. I felt that my heart of stone was taken away and replaced by a heart of flesh. Everything was different. I was a different person. And for the first time in my life, at the age of 65, I received and felt this happiness that I looked for. I received the happiness that I looked for during 65 years through money, through power, and through sex. And I could not get it. I got it for free the moment I met with Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So I looked at my right, and the first time I called my son, my son. My son, my son. What is happening to me? And he said, Dad, you are born again. So I told him, my son, tell me, who among my children, who among my four children is not yet born again? He said, they are all born again except one, your eldest son. And I said to him, what an idiot. So, idiocy change camp. Praise the Lord. Praise you, Lord. Brother and sister, I can talk to you for hours, but the time is pressing. What I can tell you, that I left everything. In 3 weeks, I left everything, all banks, all banking, all business, everything. I left everything and went to a Bible college in England. I wanted to know about Jesus Christ. At the age of 65, I went to a Bible college and left everything. And here in the Bible college, they put me later in a room, 2 meters by 3 meters, and said, you will live here. I said, me, I live here in this little room. Yes, you live here. And and you must be happy, because normally we'll put 2 in this little room. And I had to do the duties. I had to clean the floor regularly of the Bible college. I had to serve in the kitchen. Kitchen duties, they call that. 3 times per week, I had to serve in the kitchen. The others, I have to prepare the dishes. I have to prepare the table. I have to serve the food 2 times. Then I have to clean them. I have to serve the coffee. And then I have to clean everything and dry it. And then I have to clean the floor. And if it's not well done, they will ask me to do it again. I will do it again. Yes, yes, brother. Yes, brother. But I was happy. My mansion was not far, fully furnished, waiting for me. I did not want to go there. I want to stay in this little room, in this Bible college, cleaning the floor and serving the others, because this is when I was happy. This is where Jesus Christ was dwelling. Yeah. Praise God, praise God. Okay. There is so many stories, so many things I can tell you, wonderful things that happened in this Bible college, but I don't have time this time. I pray that could be another time, but there is something I need to tell you, only one thing I need to tell you. Remember, I made a deal with the Lord. I signed a contract, no sex outside marriage. And 3 months have passed, and it was very hard. So I cried to the Lord, Lord, 3 months have passed. I kept my promise, but it is very hard. I'm suffering a lot, you know, you created me like this. I'm still very, very good. So I'm suffering a lot. Please find me a solution. Please find me a solution. And the only solution, Lord, is find me a wife. Find me a wife. I'll get married to her, and I'll have sex inside marriage, and it will be fine. I'll be keeping my contract. And Lord, please hurry. And I told him, okay, look at this lady. She is from my previous life. Look how beautiful she is. She is very good for me. She is very convenient for me, Lord. She is beautiful. She is really beautiful, Lord. And she is 35 years old. This is great. I am 65. She is 35. 30-year difference. 30-year difference. It's very good. It's very good. So I prayed. No answer. No answer. Why? Because she is not a believer? Okay, Lord. Use me. Use me to minister to her. She will become a believer. Then we will serve you together. And what a testimony. I prayed. No answer. Okay. Okay, I understand. It is not sure that I could convince her to come to the Lord. And we should not get married to a non-believer. This is what the Bible says. Praise God. But Lord, look at this lady here. Look at this beautiful woman here. She is in the Bible college. She is a colleague. She's in the Bible college. She is your daughter in the Bible college. In addition, she is an intercessor. This is very good. I will preach for you. She will intercede for me. We will serve you together. And wow, receive the glory. Okay, there is a problem, I tell them. There is a problem. She is not as young as the other one. She is not 35. She is 37. But it's okay, I will accept. I prayed. No answer. No, why? Why the Lord is not answering me? Okay, I know why. The Lord wants me to be courageous. He wants to teach me courage. So he wants me to do the step myself. So the next day, I went straight to her in the church, and I told her, Linda, Linda, the Lord told me that you are going to be my wife. The eyes of Linda went out of their orbit. And she said, but George, the Lord told me and showed me. The Lord showed me who is going to be my husband. And it is not you. So my answer is no. No, nobody will ever dare say no to me. I was in desperation. And I remember one day I was in desperation and I cried to the Lord, Lord, I cannot stand anymore. Lord, it's very hard. Please find me a solution. Lord, please find me a wife. You are not answering me. But now I'm going to open the Bible. I'm going to open your word and show me in the Bible who you are going to give to, who you are going to give me as wife. Who is going to be my wife? Show me that in the Bible, in your word. And by brother and sister, I did like this. And I did fall on Malachi 2:14. Malachi 2:14. And I looked, Malachi 2:14. You cry, why? Because the Lord has witnessed the vows you and your wife made to each other on your wedding day. Because the Lord witnessed the vows you and your wife made to each other on your wedding day when you were young. But you have been disloyal to her, though she remained faithful companion, the wife of your marriage vows. So guard yourself. Remain loyal to the wife of your youth, for I hate divorce, says the Lord, the God of Israel. And I heard in my heart, return to the wife of your youth, the mother of your four children, that you left and divorced 31 years ago. And I said, excuse me, what? 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 No, 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 this is not the Lord. This is not the Lord. Lord, it is not you. I cannot return to the mother of my children that I left and divorced 31 years ago because she is old. She is old. I cannot go there. It's not you. I am only 65 years old. I am young, 65 years old. I'm young. And my wife is old, very old. She is 55 years old. And I forgot about it. This is not God. And I start knocking on doors and see who will be my wife. I knocked at doors, and all the doorways closed. It was no, 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 no. All the doorways closed, except one door, the one that leads to the mother of my children. So I obeyed the Lord, and after 31 years of divorce, After 31 years of divorce, I get remarried to the mother of my children. All my children are now united. They all love me. 3 out of 4 are serving the Lord. I have 9 grandchildren. They all love me. They used to make me a surprise in bringing the coffee in my bed and wake me up in the morning to tell me that they love me. God gave me back the years that the devil has stolen. And he wants to give you back the days that the devil has stolen. Brothers and sisters, this is the God that we serve. A God who loves us, who saved us from hell. He paid his price, the price in dying on the cross for us. He saved us because he loves us and he wants to be our daddy. He wants to take care of us. He wants to ensure all your needs. He wants to heal you. He wants to protect you from illnesses. He wants to give you a long life. He wants to give you joy and happiness. He wants to take out your heart of stone and replace by heart of flesh. He wants to give you love and happiness and joy in this life. He wants to take your problem. You will have problems, but he will take them from you. He wants to give you eternal life. You will not be afraid to die. He wants to give you all this. It's free. All this is free, brother and sister. Free. But in exchange of giving you everything, he wants everything from you. He wants everything. He is giving everything except the glory, but he wants against that everything. There is no such a thing in submitting to the Lord 99%. There is no such a thing in getting rid of all sins and keeping one sin. There is no such a thing in giving your life to the Lord and keep your girlfriend or your boyfriend. It does not work. You have to choose between your girlfriend and Jesus Christ. You cannot have them both. You have to choose between Jesus Christ and the life that you are having. You have to lead a life of holiness. Brother and sister, the word of God said, without holiness, you cannot see God. Jesus Christ came for the sinners. He is a friend of sinners. He loves sinners because he wants to save them, and he will save them. But once they are saved, they have to submit to the Lord totally. They have to change life. They have to live a life of holiness. If not, they will lose their salvation. There is no such a thing, once saved, always saved. This is wrong. This is not the Bible. Once you are saved, this is the beginning of the road of salvation. You have to continue the road. It's a difficult road. It's a narrow road, the Bible said, but Jesus will be with you and will get you through. But you have to do your part. You have to live a life of holiness. No sin, no lie, no sex outside marriage. Thank you, Lord. Jesus is calling you today. He's calling you today. And he's telling you, my children, I want to give you all this. And I want to save you. But you have to live a holy life. You have to live a holy life without sin. You have to live a life of humility. You have to live a life of forgiveness. You have to live a life of love. You have to live a life of faith. And I will help you going through that. If there is unforgiveness in your life, brother and sister, your sins are not forgiven. And if you die, you go to hell. It doesn't matter how many times you come to the church. It doesn't matter how many hours you worship. It doesn't matter if you give all the money to the poor. If there is unforgiveness in your life, if there is someone who abused you, who hurt you, and did not forgive him, you are still have the sins and you will go to hell if you die. If there is sin in your life or unforgiveness in your life, Jesus is not in you and you don't you cannot enjoy this peace and this joy and this happiness. Remember, it's all against all. All against all. Brother and sister, today the Lord is calling you. He's calling you to get a commitment with Him, to be serious with Him. All against all, brother and sister. All against all. This is the day. This is the day. And your life will never be the same again. You will test really what is happiness. You will know what I mean by happiness. You will know what the Bible said by happiness and peace and joy that surpass all understanding. For that, you have to commit to a holy life with Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is calling you to accept Him now. If you don't know this Lord I'm talking about, brother and sister, this is the day. Stand up now. Stand up now. Stand on your feet now. Just to signal that you want Jesus. You want the Jesus that I'm talking about. You want this Jesus, the Jesus of love, the Jesus that is going to change your life. The Jesus is going to give you happiness. The Jesus is going to heal you and protect you from illnesses and give you an eternal life. If you want Jesus, raise your hand. Let me see your hand. If you want Jesus, raise your hand. Thank you, Lord. Yes, that's it. Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Stand up, my daughter. Stand up. If you want the Lord, stand up. Stand up. Stand up. You have to. Glory, yes. Encourage them. Applaud them, brother and sister. Applaud them. Thank you very much. Come on. Yeah. The Lord is calling you. The Lord is calling you. The Lord is calling you. Time is passing quickly. Brother and sister, this is the day. Don't miss this opportunity. If you want the Lord to touch you and change your life, stand up as a sign of commitment to Him. Just stand up in your seat. Whenever you are, stand up. Stand up, stand up. Yes, a lot of people are hearing the voice of the Lord. He is talking to you. He is telling you, it's you. I know where you are sitting. I want you now. I called you by your name before you were born. I want you. You are mine. But stand up. Stand up in front of everybody. If you are ashamed of me in front of men, I will be ashamed of you in front of my Father in heaven. Thank you, Lord. Yes, a lot are hearing the voice of the Lord. If you are hearing the voice of the Lord, and I know a lot are hearing it, just stand up. And again, to pray with you quickly. Just stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Brother and sister, you know that the Lord is calling you. I know that a lot of people should stand up now in front of Jesus. Jesus is calling you as His disciple. And Jesus called His disciples publicly. Publicly He called disciple. Publicly. Praise your holy name. Praise your holy name. Praise your holy name. Amen, 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 amen. Okay. Please, if you are standing up, come quickly in the front. I want to pray with you. Come quickly. Come, come, my daughters. Come quickly here. Come quickly. Come quickly. Come, come, my daughter. Don't worry. Come. I'm going to pray for you, and your life is going to change. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Here are your children, Lord. Here are your children, Lord. Here are your children coming to you, Lord. Here are your disciples coming to you, Lord. Praise your holy name. 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 Amen. 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 Glory, 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 Lord, glory, 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 glory to your holy name, glory to your holy name, glory, 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 glory. This is our God. This is our God. He is calling you. He is calling you for duties. He is calling you for service. He is calling you to be in His army. Glory, Lord, glory to your holy name, glory to your holy name, glory to your holy name. The Lord needs you, brother and sister. The Lord needs you. He needs you in His army. We are at war. We are at war. You cannot be neutral. You have to take side, either the side of the kingdom of light or the side of the kingdom of darkness, but you have to take side. And today is the day of decision. Come and enroll in the army of Jesus Christ. He is calling you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We'll wait one more minute. One more minute, brother and sister, before we close the call. So hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. Don't miss the call. Thank you, Lord Jesus. 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 Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God. Okay, brother and sister, I'm going to pray with these wonderful children. I want you to stand up all, and we are going all to pray with them. All together. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Repeat this prayer after me, all of you, and especially you, from your heart. My Lord Jesus Christ, I believe that you are the Son of God. You came on earth as a man. You died on the cross for the forgiveness of my sins. You rose from the dead. And you live forever at the right hand of God the Father. Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. Forgive me my sins. Wash me with your blood. Come and live in my heart. I give you my life. And I pledge to serve you the rest of my life. I forgive all the people who offended me. And ask forgiveness for all that I have offended. I abandon sin. And I break every link with the occult. In Jesus' name. Lord, accept me in your kingdom. Glory to your holy name. 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 Brother and sister, there is a lot of healing that happened. Put quickly your hand on the place of your illness. The Lord wants to heal you. Whenever you are suffering, wherever you have a problem, put your hand on it by faith. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I command every illness to go. In the name of Jesus, I command the cancer to go. I command the back pain to go. I command the cyst to go in Jesus' name. I command AIDS to go in Jesus' name. I command heart problems to go now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Spirit of illness, I command you to go. I break every curse on your life. I cut every link with the occult. I cut every generational link. I expel all evil spirit in Jesus' name. Spirit of illness, get out of here. In Jesus' name, receive your healing. Receive your healing. Receive your healing. Receive your healing and be filled by the Holy Spirit. Fire on you. Fire, 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 fire. Fire, 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 fire. Fire, fire, fire. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Brothers and sisters, start do something you could not do before. If it's your back, bend your back. If it's your neck, turn your neck. If it's a tumor, touch the tumor. You'll see that it's gone. Thank you, Lord. There is the tumors in the breast are being healed. Tumor in the breast are gone in Jesus' name. Check it. The tumor is gone. Check your illness and come and tell the pastor later of your healing. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for what you did today. I give you the glory and honor and praise. King of kings and Lord of lords. Lord, I humble myself. I am nothing and you are everything. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. How many of you are blessed by this testimony? Let's give glory to the Lord. Hallelujah. What a testimony. እጆቻችንን ዘርግተን በቃለ ብራክ ስብሰባችን ጨርሳለን። እግዚአብሔር ይባርካችሁ ይጠብቃችሁ። እግዚአብሔር ፍቱን ያብራላችሁ ይራራላችሁ። እግዚአብሔር ፍቱ ወደናንተ ያንሳ ሰላምንም ይስጣችሁ። በስመ አብ በስመ ወልድ በስመ መንፈስ ቅዱስ አንድ አምላክ ህዝቡም ማለ በጌታ ሰላም እንሄዳለን ሁለት ሰው ሰላም ብላችሁ ትሄዳላችሁ።